you. The Rankin County District Attorney says he's upgrading charges against the 82-year-old who ran over a boy walking to a school bus. 82-year-old Raymond Watts turned himself in to police yesterday. 10-year-old Alan Lutrick died last night from his injuries. 16 WAPT's Meg Pace is live in our newsroom with what's next for the suspect. Meg.
Well, Stephanie, 82-year-old Raymond Watts is in the Rankin County Jail tonight, and he'll likely stay there until his manslaughter trial. Now, District Attorney Michael Guest tells me that Watts' age may play a role in the trial, but it didn't when a judge set his bond at $1.5 million.
You know, if this would have been a much younger individual, I believe that you probably would not have had anyone question the amount of bond that was set in the case.
82-year-old Raymond Watts is behind bars in Rankin County, charged with hitting and killing a 10-year-old boy at a school bus stop. District Attorney Michael Guest says the suspect's age won't get him any special treatment in jail.
You know, it's uncommon, I guess, to have someone of his age to be housed in a county jail waiting trial.
But Guest says age could play a huge role when a grand jury meets to consider the charges against Watts.
I'm sure the grand jury will take into consideration all the factors. The age of the victim, the fact that the victim was killed while trying to board a school bus, the age of the defendant's wife, the fact that she's what I'm told is terminally ill with cancer.
Meantime, gifts are piling up at the spot where Watts admits he hit fifth grader Alan Lutrick Tuesday morning. Just about a mile down the road, Watts' wife is home alone now, battling cancer. We tried to speak to Watts' wife Thursday. She and a few of her neighbors asked us to leave. Alan Lutrick was a student at Richland Upper Elementary. Now, crisis counselors are on hand.
I think a lot of them believed that he was going to be okay.
Tuesday, students were writing get well soon cards to Alan. Now, they're writing letters to his family.
Our hearts really go out for this family. He was a precious child, and they're wonderful people.
Now, Richland police told me Watts will have his initial court appearance Tuesday morning. District Attorney Michael Guest says that this case will likely go to a grand jury before the end of the year. Reporting live in the newsroom, Meg Pace, 16 WAPT News. Stephanie?